Hello everyone, I am Unleashed75 and this is my tutorial on how to make this lovely keypad thingy-majiggy. You can use this for like your security doors and your safe doors. Put it on your go-kart or something. It's up to you. So I got the inspiration from another YouTuber by the name of CG Monsta Tutorials. Link is in the description, so please go check her channel out and give her some love. Be nice. So I'm going to make this into a three-part video. This first part is just going to be the modeling itself. Second part will be covering the keys and the back panel. And the third part will be the main body, the metal section, and also the display. So there's going to be various different ways that you can do the display. I'm just going to cover very sort of like quickish sort of way of doing it, and everything's going to be 100% within Blender, so yeah, let's get to it. Right, so here we are inside a fresh world of Blender. Is it a world? Is it classed as a world? It's sort of like a world, yes. So I'm going to hide the tools here and also the gimbals, don't need them, and let's jump in and go into edit mode and start playing around with this cube. Saying that, down in the object data properties here under UVs, I'm actually just going to remove them. We're going to set up our own UVs, and we're also going to separate this object into various pieces. So deleting the UVs is going to save a little bit of time. Right, scale on the Y by 0.1 units. And go into face select with 3 and delete this rear face here. Right, so now I'm going to add in a loop cut with Control R, just the one right in the center. And a nice shortcut with Alt Z takes you into X-ray mode. And we're going to vertex selection with number 1, grab all of those top ones and the middle, and grab it on the Z by 1.5 units. Right, out of X-ray mode, into face select, and select these two front faces and inset them by 0.15. Okay, so I'm going to also pop up this little section here, so you can see the thickness I've done. A lot of the measurements that I've been doing will pop up here, and it makes it easier to readjust if I need to, which I'm more than likely going to. Right, so I'm going to inset again. And if I press inset while I'm still able to move this around, you can see I can still adjust it. Even if I confirmed it accidentally, you've got the option here to do the inset individual again. You've also got the measurement change in here, and I'm actually going to change it to 0.05. And then I'm going to select the lower face and extrude on the Y by 0.1 units. Before we go on to the next bit, I'm going to shift D to duplicate, P to separate it into its own item. So I'm going to rename it as keys, and the cube that we're working on at the moment rename as main body. Okay, so grab this top face, and again we're going to inset by 0.05 and then grab on the Y by 0.05. Now there is an option down here, the depth. It goes in the direction of the normals. So the grabbing that I've literally just done, that I'm still in the process of doing, which is up here, if I put in minus 0.05 here, it'd be exactly the same look as what we've got going on at the moment. Anyway, so I'm gonna enter to confirm that. I hope that made sense. Right, so shift D to duplicate this and P to separate it as a new object again. I'm going to rename this as glass, because this would be the sort of cover that covers the glass, covers the display. And I'm going to hide it from view at the moment, so I can select this face here and extrude on the Y by 0.05. Got a nice little two little bits that are inset a little bit. I don't know what I'm saying. right, so I'm going to alt select this rear edge loop and grab it on the Y by 0.1. And then I'm going to select the corner here. And then holding shift, select the other three. That clicked twice, so I'm just going to go into X-ray a minute. Make sure it is only those four that I've selected. Yep. Right, with those selected, Control B adds in a bevel, and your mouse wheel, if you scroll up and down, you can change how many segments are actually there. I'm actually going to do it manually over here. So the width I'm going to put is 0.15. And the segments I'm going to put as 8. So you see what's going on here. Right, so I'm going to alt select this edge loop here. Bring up my side panel with N and change the mean bevel weight all the way up to 1. Now, if I go into face select, I can select this face and control plus on the number pad. Do that twice. Select that one face and two extra rings above it and change the mean bevel to 1 on that as well. If you don't have the number pad on your keyboard, select this face here, come up to selection, come down to select more. And more. So now we selected two rings there. We're actually going to change the bevel on that as well to 1. And then come over to our modifiers. If we add in a bevel here and use a width of 0.01 with 4 segments. Actually, if we leave that on 1 a second, we can come up here and turn off our overlays. You see the edges that we have coming down here have been beveled as well. If we change our limit method to weight, it limits it only to where we inserted these mean bevel weights to. Yeah, that makes sense. Right, change that to 4 on the segments. We're going to come down to our object data panel and under normals we want auto smooth, and then we can come to the back area again and alt select this back ring, select edge selection first with number 2 and then try that again. So selecting all of them, shift D to duplicate, P to separate, and we're going to rename this as the back panel. Okay, so come out of edit mode, reselect our main object, right click and shade smooth. And now we should have a nice smooth object. One thing to quickly do, it's up to you, it's down to preference really. Looking at this edge here, let's hide that panel. Come into our modifiers. Actually, if we shade flat a minute, you can see what the bevel's actually doing. So these ones coming down here are very straight. And what we can do is change it with this sharp option here. Arch will actually make it so this just bends all the way around. My one that I prefer is the patch. Sort of gives you more of a smoother slope in it, all of the directions. Right, so shade smooth. Just think it personally looks a little bit better. Right, don't worry about the glitch in here. That's just our keys that are overlaying at the moment. We'll get onto them. So the back panel now. If we go into edit mode and select everything, make sure you're in either edge or vertex selection. And extrude on the Y by minus 0.1. Okay, so now we can extrude and scale. Jump into front view. Now we can actually adjust this a lot more, or as little as you want. I'm actually going to go for 1.5 and 1.3. The Y does absolutely nothing because there's no geometry on that axis. I mean, I could make this a little bit slimmer on the sides or on the top, or it's just how I like it this way. Extrude on the Y, 0.1. Well, bevel out. Well, I went bevel, extrude that way. And then just extrude and scale and just bring in X amount that you want. You're not actually going to see these back faces, so they don't matter as much. The only reason for that is so I can Alt select this edge loop, Shift Alt select here and here. And then we can bring up our mean bevel weight to 1. Now we already have the bevel modifier applied to this object because it was part of the old object. The only thing we want to do is change the width to 0.025, and that should give us, if I can see it, turn our overlays off. I picked the wrong one. We want the edge data up to 1. Okay, so that gives us a nice little bevel on the inside as well as smoothing off the outside area. Right, so we can come out of edit mode and make sure the object's selected, right click, shade smooth, double check our object data preferences on the normal is smooth is ticked. And let's hide our sidebar again. Okay, so we're almost there now. So it's just a case of doing the keys. So let's deselect everything else from view. Jump into front view and edit. We're going to add in 2 loop cuts from the bottom, 3 from the side. Select everything, right click, and edge split. So now if we go into face selection, we can grab any of these faces that we want, and you can move them wherever you want. But we're actually just going to select all of them, come up here and change our pivot point to individual. So now we can scale any size that we want and they all stay in sort of place. So I'm thinking roughly about there, which is 0.975. So if I drag select over all of them and just get rid of those extra 3s. Right, from here, I want to extrude on the Y minus 0.1. And that has just brought everything even with the front of the main unit. So we also want to scale each of those faces in a little bit. I'm thinking about there. So I'll go 0.95. Let's have a quick look. Yep, I'm happy with that. And then inset. Possibly about there. What are we looking at? So let's try 0.005. Yeah, that's okay. And then extrude, how are we going to look if we extrude? Do you want small or big buttons, do you think? Let's try 0.025. I think that's too small personally. So I'm going to times that by 2. Yep, okay, I'm happy with that. And let's hide the main body away again and select one of these rear faces. And if I do Shift G, we can select similar. And I'm actually going to pick area. So every face that has a similar area size as this one is going to highlight. Make sure nothing else is selected. And X, delete faces. Okay, bringing up our side panel again. And we select everything with A. Turn up our mean bevel all the way to 1 and jump into front view. So as you look at it, I'm going to have our numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Normally on button number 5, you'll have a little tiny little lip, a little bump on the button. I don't know if I believe it's for blind people and people that are really good at typing, so they can feel where the buttons are. So yeah, basically I'm just going to add a loop cut to this button here and then add in another loop cut, but then drag it over and confirm. And now I can G to grab, X to restrict its movement, and come over roughly about here, which is looking like 0.1. So 0.1. So now I can grab this loop cut here and grab it on the X by minus 0.1. So they're definitely like the same distance apart. Add a loop cut here and another one below, bring it up, then grab on the Z. And I'm probably looking about there, I think. I'm just looking at this face in the middle. So let's delete that. Okay, so Shift Alt and select those two together and grab on the Z and bring it down to about here somewhere. And let's check that out as 0.15. Is that too low? I think that'll be okay there. So I'm going to press I to inset that face. Press an escape because something went funny then. Undo, redo. Okay, so face select. Select that face there. Press I to inset. I've probably gone too small there. So 0.005, and now we can just play around with the depth until we get it sticking out roughly where we want it to look. Yep, I think that'll do there. And if I do Control Plus, now we've selected the next ring of faces. So if we pop it over to our modifiers and let's add in another bevel, 0.01, 4 segments, and use the weight again. And I'm going to change that to pitch once again. So now if I turn on off our overlays, you can see everything is beveled apart from our button. Bring up our side panel, we can then play around with this, and 0.5 seems good. So these ones in the middle are different setting to the outside edges. Yep, I'm happy with that. So in object mode, make sure the object is selected, right click, shade smooth, and once again our normals want auto smooth. Now you can see some strange, you might be able to see some strange lighting going on around here. Might see it a little bit clearer, nice white triangle here and here. Not exactly sure why that one's doing that, but all we have to do is come over to our hardened normals and tick that box. So we seem to be having a little bit of an issue here. So back into object mode, edit mode, bring up our panel and just drop this selection down a little bit. Here we go, 0.4 then. It was a little bit smoother anyway. Let's have a look at what the arch looks like. I think the arch looks okay. So I'm going to leave it like that. So that is our first episode fully done. We haven't saved our project yet. So Shift Control S is save as. So can I open a new folder, rename as keypad, go inside of that folder and rename our blend file as keypad. And yeah, that's part one fully done, and this is where we'll continue in the next episode, where we'll cover the numbers and the back panel. Yeah, so thanks for watching. Again, please go check out CG Monsta Tutorials. And like and subscribe to myself and her, you know. Share the love, as it were. Anyway, yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in part two. See you directly.